qui vont voir un enseignant.
Parents who go to a teacher to tell them to stop teaching cartoons are protected by freedom of speech. That will now be a criminal offense. This is extremely important. A judge will be able to say, if you are a foreigner who commits this crime, you can leave this country.
Yasser Luati is a human rights and a civil liberties activist. He is also the head of the Justice and Liberties for All Committee and joins us from Paris. How concerned are you that these measures, which Macron claims are aimed at curbing radical Islam, will only further inflame the crisis he says he's trying to fix?
Well, actually, I'm extremely concerned because the current administration is turning France into a rogue state. And I know the term may be harsh, but when you have a government waging a war on basic human rights, the right to privacy, the freedom of thought, freedom of expression, freedom of assembly, and demanding that Muslims step off and step away from any political involvement as Muslims, he's basically telling that basic human rights don't apply to Muslims. As for him to give an ultimatum of 15 days to Muslim representatives, first, that's not his job. It's a secular country. Laïcité does not allow the French president to do what he's doing. And we don't see the French president meddling in Catholic, Jewish, or Protestant affairs, yet he's doing it towards Muslims to send a message that there is definitely a connection between terrorist attacks and management of the Muslim faith. As for the organization he mentioned, the French Council of the Muslim Faith is completely illegitimate. It was set up by Nicolas Sarkozy in 2003 in clear violation of laïcité because, again, a minister of the state cannot meddle in clerical affairs. Yet they set up this organization that has no grassroots connection to the wider Muslim communities, has no women at its board, let alone at its head, and never held any free and transparent elections. So what we are doing, we see the exact same behavior as in the colonies. The state appoints representatives for Muslims and tells them exactly what's going to happen and what they should do. And actually, these Muslim representatives actually represent the state towards Muslims and not vice versa.
Do you think that this is just the start of further, even stricter measures in France against Muslims?
I mean, you know, it's been going on for nearly a decade. You know, Muslims have been losing their human rights and civil liberties for years because, you know, the French government has becoming ever more, feeling threatened with the rising social discontent. So they're using Muslims as scapegoats to pass security measures and to delegitimize the very notions of equality, freedom, and human rights. And right now, even in 2015, 16, 2018, the UN has constantly warned France about its crackdown against Muslims. And what Emmanuel Macron is doing right now is literally saying, we are gloves off, we are going to go full speed ahead and then demand that Muslims abide by the demands we ask him. And unfortunately, Emmanuel Macron is fueling again the problems he's supposedly trying to fix.
All right, let's leave it there. Yasser Luata, thank you so much for your time today.